Reconciliation in our country. My brothers and sisters, let us call to mind our sins so as to prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries. You came to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, from whom all good things come, grant that we who call on you in our need may at your prompting discern what is right, and by your guidance do it. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Couple of sticks to go in and prepare something for you. we have eaten it, we shall die. Elijah said to her, Do not be afraid. Go and do as you propose. But first, make me a little cake and bring it to me. Then you can prepare something for yourself and your son. For the Lord, the God of Israel, says, The jar of flour shall not go empty, nor the jug of oil run dry, until the day when the Lord sends rain upon the earth. She left and did as Elijah had said. She was able to eat for a year, and Elijah and her son as well. The jar of flour did not go empty, nor the jug of oil ran dry, as the Lord had foretold through Elijah. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
When I call, answer me, O my just God. You who relieve me when I am in distress, have pity on me and hear my prayer. Men of rank, how long will you be dull, O heart? Why do you love what is vain and seek after falsehood?
Lord, let your face shine on us.
Know that the Lord does wonders for his faithful ones. The Lord will hear me when I call upon him. Tremble and sin not. Reflect upon your words in silence.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
O Lord, let the light of your countenance shine upon us. You put gladness into my heart, more than when grain and wine abound.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
Alleluia.
Father, will you trust in the Lord till I die?
comes to mind this morning is because of what happened powerfully in our first reading. A widow is at her wit's end in a time of famine, and she and her son have very little flour and very little oil in their jars. And she's saying to herself that this is probably the time we're going to die, for there's nothing being grown in the land at the time. But the prophet Elijah comes to her house, and he asks her quite simply, do you trust what I'm telling you, that God will provide, and that you will not run out until the rains will return to the land? So said, so done, when the rains did return, never did her jar of oil or flour run empty. That requires supernatural trust. And very often in our own lives, we feel that we cannot trust God to that extent. The same God who will bring us out of situations that are dice in our lives is the same God who will bring us to a place we never thought before, if we trust in his providence. But the trust in providence requires us to have a spirit of poverty. What does that mean? It means that before the Son of God, you and I are beggars. No worse, no different than the next person. But you and I are throwing ourselves at the throne of God, asking for the things that we do not think we're deserving of. Hence why Christ teaching the apostles how to pray is very powerful. We're to pray as such, our Father who art in heaven, and that request that we make for our daily bread. In the Latin, it's super substantial bread, bread that will never run out, bread that will never fail, and a bread that will satiate every hunger and thirst that we have. A bread provided for us in the sacrament of this altar, the very gift of God's living, enduring, and real presence in this world. And that in these times, as we watch a nation come out of quarantine and pandemic, but still in the grips of social injustice, we have to place our trust in the Lord. Trust that God will lead us to the paths of justice and peace. Trust that God will restore tranquility to our land, but also trust that God will provide for us even when we don't know how those promises will unfold in our lives. May the church say it.
Amen.
Almighty God, incline your ear to our humble prayers and supplications. For all priests and pastors, may the Lord continue to bless them and strengthen them in faith. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For world leaders, may the Spirit of wisdom guide their work of governance in justice and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all members of our family of faith, may the Lord's goodness continue to shine upon us and make us holy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who have died, may the Lord joyfully welcome them into his heavenly banquet. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And for the prayers and petitions we hold in the silence of our hearts and minds. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Gracious Lord, hear the prayers of your people, which we offer you with sincere hearts, in a spirit of trust and poverty, and answer them in accordance with your divine will. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of the hand, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, and it will become our spiritual bread.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the glory of his holy church.
Look kindly upon our service, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer may be an acceptable oblation to you, and lead us to grow in charity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right to give you thanks, truly just to give you glory, Father most holy, for you are the one God, living and true, existing before all ages, and abiding for all eternity, dwelling in unapproachable light. Yet you, who alone are good, the source of life, have made all that is, so that you might fill your creatures with blessings, and bring joy to many of them by the glory of your light. And so in your presence are countless hosts of angels, who serve you day and night, and gazing upon the glory of your face, glorify you without ceasing. With them, we too confess your name in exaltation, giving voice to every creature under heaven as we acclaim. Bringing to perfection perfection his work in the world, he might sanctify creation to the full. Therefore, O Lord, we pray, may the same Holy Spirit graciously sanctify these offerings, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, for the celebration of this great mystery, which he himself left us as an eternal covenant. For the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, Father most holy, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. And while they were at supper, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, taking the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, he gave thanks and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we pour out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mysterium Fidei. We proclaim his resurrection and his ascension to your right hand, and as we await his coming in glory, we offer you his body and blood, the sacrifice acceptable to you, which brings salvation to the whole world. Look, O Lord, upon the sacrifice which you yourself have provided for your church, and grant in your loving kindness to all who partake of this one bread and one chalice, that gather into one body by the Holy Spirit, they may truly become a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your glory. Therefore, Lord, remember now all from whom we offer the sacrifice, especially your servant, Francis, our Pope, Nicholas, our Bishop, his assistant bishops, all the clergy, those who take part in this offering, those gathered here before you, your entire people, and all who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember also those who have died in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead, whose faith you alone have known. To all of us, your children, grant, O merciful Father, that we may enter into a heavenly inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your apostles and saints in your kingdom. There, with the whole of creation, free from the corruption of sin and death, may we glorify you through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in my unity of love, all glory and honor is yours forever. simply dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to suffer the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be
The Lord is my rock, my fortress, and my deliverer. My God is my saving strength. The body of Christ. 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 those watching this Mass via Facebook Live and later today on YouTube, we pray together an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things. I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you're already there, and yet unite myself fully to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. May your healing work, O Lord, free us, we pray, from doing evil, and lead us to what is right, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
One very brief announcement. For all those watching via Facebook Live, you know that Our Lady of Victory is open for private prayer and devotion from 9 to 11, and again to 12 to 3. And now, Timothy Claver Church is also open for private prayer and devotion from 12 to 4. Tomorrow, we will have the Sacrament of Reconciliation. If anyone desires to go to confession, Father Cox and myself will be available here at the church from the hours of 1 to 3 here at Lady of Victory. So if you've been away from the sacrament and desire to go to confession, Father Cox and I are available here at Our Lady of Victory from 1 p.m. to 3 p.m. Thank you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.